Good morning, everyone, and thank you for starting your day out with me. I'm Jenna Stauffer. I'm pleased this morning to have on U.S. Representative Joe Garcia. Now, he is among the newest members of Congress. He is also the first Democratic congressman of Hispanic descent in Florida. He will be representing the newly drawn 26th congressional district, which of course includes Southwest Miami-Dade County and the Florida Keys. Joe, thank you so much for being on with me this morning.
It's a tremendous pleasure. Thank you for having me.
How is this trip to Key West?
There's never a bad trip to Key West. As we were leaving Washington this morning, it was snowing, so it's wonderful
to
be
here. So you are very happy.
I'm always happy to be in the Keys. and if I'm not happy, they make me happy. So we're good.
Good. Well, we're happy to have you here. And I just want to get right in to some different issues here in Monroe County specifically. Let's talk about wastewater funding. What are your plans to continue federal wastewater funding down here?
Well, clearly the federal government allocated money a long time ago, but they didn't actually fund the programs. In other words, they passed legislation with your previous Democratic Congressman Peter Deutsch when he was your representative over a decade ago. And so what we've got to do is now make we've got to put the funding towards that appropriation. Clearly, wastewater costs are tremendously high, but they've had tremendous benefit for the Keys. You know, we've seen the fishing populations improve, water quality improve. We've also got to make sure we do that here in Key West. We're still having a lot of leaching and we're still having water quality issues. So we've got to make sure we get the federal grants available. We've got to make sure we fund the underlying programs. I'm working with city leaders and county leaders to make sure we access those funds, not only down here, but in Isla Mirada, where they've had great cost. One of the advantages is that we put these systems together with other systems, it'll bring the cost a little bit down, and long-term we'll pay down that debt.
Okay, let's go into another pressing issue, and that is, of course, immigration. What do you feel about Obama's immigration plan?
Well, look, I'm in a unique position. I'm on the Judiciary Committee of the United States House of Representatives, and I'm on the Immigration Subcommittee. Look, this is a very important issue. First off, it's important for the Keys, but it's also important for all of South Dade. What we want to do is we want to make sure these people pay their back taxes, learn English, get in the back of the line, but give them a pathway forward. When folks have a pathway forward, they invest in their community, they buy houses. They are part of us going forward, and no place feels that more than the Florida Keys, where you have a lot of folks that come down here, and the great need for workers that we have, and the expense of being down here is so difficult that sometimes, you know, we can't find the right workers, and so a lot of undocumented folks fill these spots. Well, I think with an immigration system that works, what it allows us to do is, not only do we need these folks to be legalized and find a pathway forward as long as they meet all the requirements and pay all their penalties, but we also need to find ways to attract the very best and brightest to our country. You know, Jenna, if I was studying, nuclear medicine at a top school in our country, and I decided I wanted to stay here, although I was from China, there's no way for me to stay. And so we lose a person, they go to another country, they create jobs there, and their competition to us. What we need to do is find a pathway for those very productive students that are coming to the best university system in the world, which is the American one, give them a way forward. Likewise, we've got to be able to take top people that we need in areas we need. For example, down here in the Keys, finding primary care pediatricians is very difficult. And so if we can find ways to find people in particular areas that we need for our economy in certain areas of the country and offer them visas here, well, that's always a good thing, right? So we bring in those physicians so we can give that kind of basic coverage to our folks and make sure that it grows our economy. So I'm a big believer that when we have an immigration system that works, our country grows. And in the end, we're all immigrants. This is a country of immigrants, but we have to have a process where we know who these folks are. You know, a lot of people think when they talk about broken immigration, they talk about our border. Well, last year, United States government spent $18 billion on securing our border. That's more than we spend on the FBI. So we've reached a sort of saturation level. Now what we've got to do is, instead of continue spending that money, is find a system that works. Mm-hmm. Nearly half of the people that are here didn't come through the border. They just flew in and overstayed their visa. Mm-hmm. And so what we need to do is have a system where we can track people who come in, where we know where they are, where we make sure they go home if we don't want them to be long-term stays. And then we've got to give immigration judges the discretion. You know, it used to be that you know, you'd committed some infraction 20 years ago, and then you met someone in the United States, you married them, but now, because you committed that infraction, you got to leave the country and wait a certain amount of time. Well, people who have families aren't going to do that. So we need to have a system where immigration judges have some discretion to fix those problems along the way. I think the country is headed in the right direction. I think Republicans are finally seeing the light here. We've watched Senator Marco Rubio, who was on one extreme of the issue, evolve, and it's always good to have someone embrace an evolutionary pattern on migration that makes sense long-term for South Florida.
Okay, well, you just mentioned Marco Rubio. Let's talk about him, his immigration plan. What do you like and dislike?
Well, I think he's come a long way from where he was. He was in a very bad place, as were the majority of Republicans. And, you know, when somebody starts moving your direction, you don't criticize it. You just say thank you and welcome. But the reality is, I think the pathway should be to citizenship needs to be much more reasonable. I also think we need to give LGBT folks a way to. You know, the other day I was speaking with someone from South Florida, and they were in the process of hiring a museum curator, and they had offered this job to a very renowned guy. And he said, look, I'll come, but my partner has to be able to come, and U.S. immigration system has nothing, same-sex partners, there's no way to be included in the immigration system. Marco Rubio doesn't agree with that. I do. I think we have to fix the immigration system, and there are literally, we lose thousands of talented people who literally can't get their life partners into the system, or their spouse into the system. And so I think Marco is probably wrong there. But hopefully, you know, he's evolved thus far pretty much. So we got to keep him headed in the right direction.
Right. Who knows what can happen.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
Well, thank you. I know there's many more issues I'd love to talk with you about. So we'll have to have you come on sometime in the future.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And if you have any issue you want to speak to us about, we've got Jen George, which is our Monroe County District Representative, District Director. And she's out of the Gatto Building on the first floor. She's got a beautiful art collection there. You can come and critique it and join us.
Wonderful. And she's a good girl too, so talk with her.
She's a wonderful girl. Let me use the term girl. She's absolutely wonderful woman who's really becoming a conch, and we really appreciate the way that community leaders have worked with her, and we look forward to working with them.
Great. Well, I look forward to doing more with you. Thank you for being on. I'm going to take a quick break right now. Stay with me.